Hi, I'm Judy Green and I'd like to welcome you to NatChat, and today we're going to talk about getting into the film business or not. So my very special guest is John Powell from AAM and Richard Norton, who I know quite well, an actor. Okay, good morning. Hi John and hi Richard. Good to see you both. So John, I know you and your wife Wendy have a very successful management agency. Mm. How did that first come about?
Well, I started off 30 odd years ago as a teacher. I was a drama teacher. I got involved with amateur theatre. From amateur theatre I got myself an agent in those days and started on the Sullivans. Got into music theatre, did music theatre for a while. I was then back into television and left the teaching, luckily, which was nice because I wasn't a very good teacher. I had no great commitment.
Or patience? Or
probably all of that. Probably all of that, you know, with my personality. But after quite a while, I went overseas with my ex-wife. I worked in television industry overseas, advertising agencies. I came back here, got back into the acting. I met Wendy, my wife now, and she was working for a company, or she had her own company called Melbourne Speakers at that stage. And the agency that I was with, the chap Brian was getting close to retirement agency, and we just put it to Brian one day, look, you know, when you are looking to retire, we'd be interested in possibly buying the agency. And after 2 years that came about, and we changed the name from Active Casting to Active Artist Management because we wanted to go to a different level. And Brian had done a fantastic job lifting the agency to where he had, but we wanted to take it further. And with Wendy's skills, as far as running her own businesses, which she used to, she ran her own businesses in the 80s, had a company called Monkeys of Melbourne. So she had a very good business brain. And we just thought, well, look, we'll give this a go, see what happens. And we did. And 11 years later, we're still there, which is great.
And I thought it was funny when I first met you and Wendy, I thought you were both so much fun. And sometimes the connotations of an agent and how scary it might be, you know, I think a lot of people think that. But
I mean, some of my friends would probably say, you know, from in the past, it was like, oh, you know, we'll get the life of the party around and we'll get Powell around. So I tended to do some silly things. But yeah, some people have the view that you should be a certain way. So you know, you're dealing in business, you're dealing with people, you're trying to get people work. So in that sense, you know, you have to be as straight as you possibly
can. And I'd say for sure, you having experience in acting, being on the other side, you're also probably not sympathetic, you know, whatever the word is, you know, for actors. And actually, Richard, you being an actor, how did you get into acting?
Quite by accident. Did you know, I went over to California in 1979 as a personal bodyguard to Linda Ronstadt. And I was working with Fleetwood Mac, David Bowie, and previously I'd met Chuck Norris in Australia. And Chuck said, give him a call if I ever got to California and we'll do some training. And that was like a dream come true for me as a martial artist, because Chuck was such a legend, especially in those days. So I started training with Chuck, and he happened to be in pre-production for one of his very first movies called The Octagon. And he knew I could handle a lot of Japanese weapons and do all the fight stuff. So I ended up working on that, playing the main bad guy. And that led on to quite a number of movies with Chuck. And I just suddenly thought, wow, this is not a bad way to make a living. You know, this is fun. You get to travel the world and be on different sets, meet different martial artists, because it was very action-based, my career. And that's how it went. But again, when I went over the States, I had no aspirations whatsoever to be an actor. So it was really a case of just being in the right place at the right time.
No, I know, because prior to that, you were actually a public servant and working with the immigration department. So, I mean, I like to bring this up because, you know, you never know when someone wants to start their acting career.
Thank you, Judy, for bringing that up.
There you go.
I was an interviewer at the immigration department for 10 years. And I did my training and everything before that, after that. And so I know what that side of life is about, the 9 to 5. And I've got to tell you, I actually really enjoyed my time there when I did it. When I left and went to the States, of course, it was like just jumping in to talk about a whole new world. But it was fantastic, you know. So as a life experience, I enjoyed the whole process.
That would have been fascinating.
And how did you find John as your agent?
How did I come across, John? I worked on a movie called The Condemned in Queensland with Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vinnie Jones, and I was doing the fight coordinating. And Andy McPhee, a very fine actor, was working on The Condemned, and I'd mentioned to Andy that I really need to get representation here in Australia. And he said, oh, I know just the person. You should go to Active Artist Management and meet John and Wendy. And he introduced me to them, and that was it. Away we went.
Fantastic. So, Richard, I know you've been a hunky hero and an action star, so I think we'd better let the viewers at home have a look at some of your work. So, okay, hold on tight, everyone. We're just going to show some of Richard's action work.
When I see Richard Norton, he can act.
Well, souvenired, he would have called it.
He can do comedy.
You're an accountant, right?
He can do serious. He knows the rhythm. The rhythm is for us, is very important. I fight with a lot of people, they really can fight. Boom, boom, bang, 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 bang. What we want is bang, 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 bang. And he knows the rhythm and he knows the timing. Show the power, but doesn't hurt. Of course, we do touch. Bam! It's not bam. So this is why I like Rich Norton.